Hello everybody, welcome to my movement guide for Ninja Gaiden Black and Ninja Gaiden. Everything I say here pretty much applies to Ninja Gaiden 1, well, which is NGO, and Ninja Gaiden Black. There are a couple of things that are a little bit different just because of they did speed up some of the stuff between NGO and NGB. But pretty much everything I say here, you know, is applicable across all those games, you know, like NGO, NG, Black and Sigma. It does have some differences for Sigma because of the different role animations that they put in. But for the most part, you know, this is to be applied to Ninja Gaiden Black. So I hope this is synced properly. I did try this video a couple of ways, but the only way that I could really get it to really explain kind of how this stuff works is by showing my hands and the pad, so I can really kind of show the inputs for the various things that I'm going to be doing. So I want to cover in this video just kind of the real basics of movement. Movement is one of those things in NGB, you know, probably noticed if you've seen any of like the recent commentary stuff I've done with Big Al, it's one of those things that is extremely important, but it's also one of those things that you're never really going to get a good idea from just by watching a video. You're never really going to get the motivations behind a player's movement by watching what they do, because, you know, it's all reactionary. It's not something that you commit to. You know, committing to movement is generally the worst thing you can do in Ninja Gaiden, because that's how you're going to get hit, you know, either in the air or when you land. So I have kind of a list of topics that I just want to go over, and hopefully by the end of, you know, covering all those, you know, for anybody wanting to kind of get into the game and, you know, having a better understanding of movement, this video will help. So the first basic really is, you know, kind of what everybody finds out, you know, when you figure out you can roll jump. Is roll jumping in multiple directions. Roll jumping in the same direction is, you know, pretty much the fastest way to move. But roll jumping in multiple directions is, you know, is the key to your defense, because a lot of the attacks that the enemies have will actually, you know, follow you. That, and like crab fiends are a really good example. When you roll jump one way and then jump in the other, they have their scoop attack that will pretty much always hit you out of the kind of lifting frames of the jump. You know, that's where you're vulnerable, where Ryu initially leaves the ground. So what you want to do, just for example on that attack, is you want to roll forward, or, well, generally just roll away from that enemy, and then roll and then jump in a different direction to cause his attack to whiff. And that's kind of like the real basic of why you want to learn to, you know, use roll jumping in multiple directions. Awakened Alma and Initiate's Fireballs are another good example. That attack is, you know, you really need to be able to roll jump in extremely precise different directions in order to be able to dodge those fireballs successively. You know, just roll jumping constantly, you know, to one direction or the other will get you hit. So with that in mind, I just want to kind of go over how you do it and just kind of, as best as I can, demonstrate my inputs on the controller. So to roll, obviously, you just press block and the direction you want to roll in. It's all relative to the direction that Ryu is facing. So if I just turn Ryu around so he faces towards the camera, and you then want to roll, you know, to his back, in this case forward in the sense that the screen is, you would press up and block at the same time, and that works exactly the same for everything else. You press back to go back, right to go right, and then left to go left. And if you want to roll like in a diagonal direction, like, you know, diagonal up, like up to the right, say, you just push it kind of, you know, the direction up to the right. And that's kind of where we get into the jump start, like, you know, how you would actually start jumping after that. Whatever direction you roll in, if you do not alter the direction with the joystick, the frames, for lack of a better word, will carry over into the jump. So if I just roll and then press A, Ryu will always jump in that direction, and I won't even have to press, you know, I can let go of the stick completely. You can keep it held, but, you know, I can, I'm going to roll to the forward of the screen now, and then just let go of the stick, and Ryu will just jump in that direction. So you can choose there, like, he just jumps in that direction even though I let go of the stick. And that is kind of the introduction to how you change his direction when you land. You have more than enough time to, you know, redirect him and redirect the jump. So let's say you just want to roll in front of him and then roll in front of him and then jump to the right. You would roll forward, and then as you're coming out of the roll animation, change the where before, where I actually took my thumb off the stick, instead of taking it off, you just want to press right and then jump like that, and that will give you your directional roll jump. Now that is kind of a simple way to explain the execution behind it, but the more complicated ways is when you want to roll jump in more precise directions. Like, roll jumping to, say, the right and then left, you know, is fairly straightforward, or right then left, or back, you know, or down then front, and or up and back. The complicated ways to do this is when you want to kind of do it in combat and roll around attacks. So let's say, for example, you are in a cat fiend encounter. I'm just trying to think of enemies that would be good for this. This would be pretty much impossible to demonstrate live because, you know, I just wouldn't be able to keep up. You know, the fight would go by too quickly. So let's say, for example, you are fighting in a cat fiend encounter and they have their guard crush attack where they try and, like, looks like they try and hug you, but they're obviously just trying to swipe you. And when you roll, you know, that roll isn't going to give you enough of a, you know, put enough distance between you to cause that attack to whiff. It's going to get you. And coming out of the roll is when it is most likely to guard crush you. And also when you jump, you know, in the kind of leaving the ground frames of the jump, that attack is going to get you in the air. So to evade that attack, it's probably a really good example to use that one, thinking about it, is you would want to roll. And then do not jump in the same direction, because then that attack is still going to get you. And you want to put more distance between you and that enemy. So you would roll one way and then jump in a diagonal way as you're coming out of the roll animation. So for example, on this one, I'm just going to roll forward and then jump diagonally to the left. Like that. As you can see, I started out straight on these squares. This is why I chose the stadium for this, by the way, just because it's a pretty good way to, you know, demonstrate directions. Like, I'll do it now, I'll roll to the front and then jump to the diagonal right. You know, it's not a straight diagonal. That was a pretty hard right. I'll do it more kind of diagonally this time. And that's where I want to kind of get into one thing that I found out, you know, while trying to do this video in previous iterations. It's not something that I found out per se, it's just something that I realized I do all the time, but never really thought anything of it because I do it so much that it's just become second nature. You've probably already seen me do it in this video without me mentioning it yet. It's your camera movement while moving Ryu. The camera in this game is fantastic if you know how to use it. And it's not perfect by any means. You know, it can always kind of, you know, get trapped in corners and stuff. But for the most part, it is really, really good. It's just kind of tricky to master it. So, for example, when you're roll jumping, what I kind of do out of force of habit, unless I need to, you know, keep a certain enemy on screen or something, like if I'm fighting berserkers or something like that, I'm always going to hit the right trigger as soon as I've put in the roll. As soon as I've put in the roll command, like just after I press roll, I'm tapping that right trigger. That's the center of the camera behind Ryu's back. Because if you start roll jumping in multiple directions, you can kind of see that the camera soon ends up in a really shitty, really shitty place. Like, you know, I have like zero visibility here in this corner. Like, that platform and the wall are taking up about 40% of the screen in that position. So if I was to do that sort of movement again into the bottom of the screen, I would put the camera behind Ryu as soon as I put in that roll command. So I would roll jump like this, try and end up in the same spot, and as you can see now, I have far more visibility of the enemies around me. If there is an enemy behind this platform here, I'm going to be able to see him. If there's an enemy to my right, I'm going to be able to see him. If there's enemies coming at me from Ryu's back in this angle, I'm going to be able to see him. Whereas opposed to this angle, I'll try and recreate it as best as I can. It's about like that, I think. But yeah, as you can see here, if there is an enemy like behind that platform, I'm not really going to have a good angle on him or have a good idea of where he's moving to. And if there's an enemy to kind of the upper left of where that platform is right now in the corner, I'm not going to be able to see that enemy at all. Whereas if I have the camera down here, you know, I have full visibility of this side of the platform. This is me moving the camera to kind of demonstrate my point. This is, you know, where the camera ended up roughly. But again, that's just something that is second nature once you've played this game for a while, but something that, you know, honestly, until I started kind of trying to find a way to do this video, I never even thought of, you know, like, that is just something that I do all the time. And camera movement as well, when you're moving, it's just something that is so incidental to movement and being able to move well and keep all your enemies on screen or more importantly, I should say, the enemies that you want to be on screen when you're moving. So that pretty much covers just general roll jumps. There is more stuff I could explain, well, there is more stuff I could show, but I don't think it would really be that helpful. You know, the directions really are precise. You know, you really can kind of roll in kind of the 8 main directions, you know, like your north, south, east and west, and then, you know, the all individual directions between there. And that's really what gives you the best movement. You know, it's being able to roll, you know, in a diagonal direction and then jump in a completely opposite one. I'm just going to kind of show some basic roll jumping here, just so you can see my hands and what I'm doing without me, you know, trying to talk over it. So here goes. So that just kind of shows you what my hands are doing while I'm roll jumping. Now, as you can see there, it's force of habit, but I actually did some on-landing jumps in that section, which I'm going to get into now. I want to try and explain the on-landing frames of when you come out of any jump. Any jump is going to give you on-landing frames. And what they are is they are frames where you can buffer in other moves. There's not a lot that you can't buffer in off on-landing frames. Neutral rotate moves are one of them, like the Gleaming Blade. I mean, it only really applies to the Gleaming Blade, because the Gleaming Blade, you know, you have the regular version and you have the, you know, hold Y version. Whereas if you buffer in your full circle Y in your on-landing frames, you're always going to get a regular Gleaming Blade. And I'll go into how to get that move to come out in a second, because I'm just kind of getting ahead of the on-landing frames here. So, and how these factor into movement is pretty basic. When you land, you can buffer in the direction of your next roll. So I'm just going to roll jump here, and then roll jump forward in my on-landing frames, and then just let go of the stick. As you can see, I let go of the stick there just as it came out, and he went forward. And you can use that in the exact same way that I showed before, how you can use your roll jumping. So you could roll jump one way. I'm just going to roll jump forward here, and then roll to the right. Just like that. And this is kind of where all that movement comes from. It's being able to input your, you know, it's being able to take note of what's around you, take note of what's going on, and then input your on-landing jumps and on-landing rolls as you land. And you really want to be thinking about this kind of 3 moves in advance. You know, that sort of thing really is impossible to explain. If you watch kind of some of the boss fight videos where I'm fighting bosses, you'll probably see me do it, and that can kind of give you an idea of what I'm doing. So, for example, to kind of roll jump around, you know, Alma's fireballs or something like that, you want to, as soon as that attack starts up, you want to sort of, you know, take note of where you are in relative to those fireballs, where they're going to start trying to hit and track you, and then do your movement around that. As I said, kind of 3 or 4 moves in advance. So you would say roll jump, start roll jumping to the right, and then jump forward to alter their arc. And then as you're coming out of that jump, you need to think, right, they're going to try and track me there, so I need to put more distance between me, and then input an on-landing roll so you can roll to the right, and then just, you know, keep doing this kind of motion. And this is similar to how you get your on-landing jumps to come out, and I'll get into that in just a second. The last thing I want to talk about with regards to on-landing rolls is you will need to alter the direction on the stick when you land. If you just let it carry on, not only will Ryu actually run, which is the worst thing you can really do because it's incredibly vulnerable, but then you will also get just the same direction rolled again. So if you do this and then, you know, let him run, he's just going to carry on running, stop and then block, and then your forward roll will probably come out because you've mistimed it. So what that looks like is just simply roll jumping, flicking the stick as you land, and then, you know, then you will go into neutral, and then you can put in your jump. So it's roll jump, flick it as you land, and then, you know, flick the stick to jump an A in the direction that you want to jump in. So if you do that but keep either the stick and block pressed in and put in a jump, then not only is your jump not going to come out, but Ryu is going to run like that. And then, you know, I mean, I pressed A there, but I'll do it again just in case it wasn't obvious. But, you know, if you keep block pressed, you know, you will be blocking. Like, if an attack comes at you, you will be blocking. But, you know, you want to avoid blocking as much as possible, really. You know, you just want to avoid getting hit or even blocking an attack. Because when you're blocking an attack, you know, another one can come and surprise you. So that's going to kind of transition into on-landing jumps. Now, these are probably one of the trickiest things to time, purely because the level of ground that you're on will alter them. And now that I think about it, I have the stairs here, which I can kind of demonstrate on. But when you do an on-landing jump, you'll know if you keep the stick, if you keep your thumb on the stick, then you're just going to jump in that same direction, and you'll notice there that's not an on-landing jump. Ryu is taking a couple of steps. An on-landing jump is done by when you land off a jump, you let go of the analog stick completely, and then you put in the direction that you want to jump in an A at the same time. You would press both of them together. If you do it correctly, you won't even see the step come out, what Ryu takes. I'm going to do it now, and I'll delay the input a little bit so you can see Ryu alter his direction. Like there. You can see him alter the direction that he's then going to jump in. Whereas if you input it as soon as he lands, you know, it kind of looks like he's hopping off the floor immediately as he lands. Like that. You don't even see his step come out. And this can be done pretty much in any direction other than Ryu's back. That's a separate segment that I wanted to cover, so I'll get into that in a minute. So that is how you on-landing jump. And you can do this, you know, as I said, as long as you don't go to Ryu's back, you can do this indefinitely. You know, this is marginally quicker than roll jumping on the surface. It's just that the reason roll jumping is quicker to get around in terms of combat is that you can transition out of rolls into jumps faster than you can jumps to jumps, like that, and you can kind of do your acrobat stuff coming out of it. So, you know, they are pretty much on par in terms of just general movement speed. The big disadvantage that on-landing jumps have is that obviously when you're around enemies, jumps are far less safer than rolls are, because in those, you know, you're vulnerable in the jumping frames, and you're vulnerable in the frames that you're leaving the ground, and you're also vulnerable in the initial frames that you land on the ground. So, you know, roll jumping really is just superior in that aspect in every way. Now, the final thing I did want to cover, I'll talk about the on-landing stuff on surfaces. As you can see here, you will need to know, because that is a raised surface, Ryu's feet are going to touch the ground, you know, sooner than they would. So, you know, you need to alter your inputs to take into account, you know, uneven surfaces. Otherwise, you will get, you know, you'll get the forward animation where he then walks forward and jumps, and that's exactly what you don't want. So now I just want to get into the final thing, knowing what the movement can't do, which is continuous movement in the direction of Ryu's back. And what that means is, you notice here, like, I can roll forward and then, like, press roll to roll backwards, and then he won't actually roll backwards. You know, he will just, like, transition almost completely into his standing animation. You can roll and then jump backwards, and that's kind of the key. You have to do one and then the other. You can never do both. You cannot do an on-landing jump and then an on-landing jump immediately behind him. Like, there is, I mean, that looks, it still looks pretty fast, but, you know, if you compare that to, you know, just general on-landing jumps, you know, you can see how much faster the on-landing jump is rather than that one right there where he jumps, you know, in the direction of Ryu's back. And again, as I said, that will count for rolls, so you can't roll jump, and then, you know, jump immediately backwards, which is unfortunate, but it's, you know, I would say that kind of comes across as a design choice. You never really need to do that, and it doesn't really feel natural to do it anyway. So the final thing I wanted to talk about was just go back really quick to the on-landing frames and how to manipulate them. There really isn't much you can't do out of on-landing. Of course, everybody should know the on-landing UT. You know, you just hit Y as soon as you're going to go into on-landing frames. Knowing how to do that out of every single aspect of a jump is essential. You know, jumping off that platform there, knowing when his feet are going to hit the floor, jumping up on the platform, knowing when his feet are going to hit, jumping up, you know, throwing shurikens, knowing when his feet are going to hit. You know, never ever missing an on-landing is critical. It's absolutely essential, because if you do miss an on-landing, you'll get... I do this a lot, so it's kind of hard for me to not do it. Okay. There we go. You'll get that. And that is, without a doubt, the worst move in the game. That move is... it looks really cool when you chop off enemies' heads, but it's terrible. And, you know, when you miss timing on landing, that's what you're going to get. So, I want to talk about kind of, you know, buffering in moves off of on landing. A great one with the Dragon Sword is its forward X, the Windmill Slash, which has got the exact same invulnerability flames as the roll. It actually has a little bit more, now that I remember. It has ever so slightly more invulnerability than the roll, and you can do that out of a jump, and you can land input forward and X, that was X, sorry. Input forward and X, and you'll get an on-landing roll. And you can do that in any direction, you know, even to his back, which is the way it differs in a roll. And then you can, you know, take that into another roll if you wanted to, or take it into a jump. And the last thing I wanted to talk about was how to get neutral moves to come out of on-landing. It's not truly instant, but it is pretty quick, and that's when you would roll jump, and then do this move instead of getting an on-landing Gleaming Blade. So if you just do roll jump and then buffer in your forward Y before you land, you'll get the Gleaming Blade every time. Whereas if you want to get the regular version like that, you need to wait a split second before you buffer in that rotate on the joystick, because then Ryu will have transitioned into standing frames and he won't be in on-landing frames, which is what causes the on-landing Gleaming Blade to come out. Now, when you're used to, if you're new to this, you will kind of get a little bit of movement on Ryu on the ground as he hits the ground to do that. If you time it perfectly, you know, you will not see any movement. You will just see a smooth, just regular rotate Y. This is probably one of the hardest things to learn how to time, and it's really not all that useful. It's just one of those things you can do, and I just wanted to try and cover everything I could. You know, with regards to movement. The final thing I wanted to talk about was just kind of Ryu's acrobatic stuff, you know, which is just wall running, wall clings, and wall jumps. And when you come out of wall runs, you will have the exact same on-landing properties that you do out of a regular jump. So you can do just a wall run and let him kind of fall off it, which is when you just let go of the stick. And the same thing will happen when the wall run runs out. You will have the exact same thing coming out of, you know, multiple wall jumps. You'll have the exact same thing off the flying bird flip. You know, and again, you have the exact same on-landing frames. So, you know, doing this into an on-landing roll to reuse back and then jumping to the right. For example, you would do a flying bird flip, on-landing roll, flip the camera behind him, and then as the camera moves, move the stick to the right and then press A. That would work the same for, you know, the regular one where you jump off the wall, like that. So that pretty much does cover movement. I realise that it might not seem... I do wonder how helpful this guide will be, because this is just kind of a guide on how to do this stuff. Going into kind of how to use it is a whole other thing entirely. I am just going to play this fight real quick in the staircase, just to see if this helps. This might kind of show this stuff kind of in practice, so I'm just going to try and play this like as I would. Like that follow-up attack probably would have hit me if I didn't go out of it. That is one of those attacks that you always want to roll jump in a different direction, because they will track how you come out. Here again, just like those two enemies, like knowing where that crab fiend was, that he's going to try and attack me off screen when I come out of my rolls. Roll jumping to the left there to get out of the way of him. Yeah, so I'm just going to play this fight now, and hopefully some of this stuff will seem, you know, obvious. So that about does it for this video. I really hope this does help people kind of get a grasp on movement. it is one of those things you just need to practice at. It might sound like an exaggeration, but you know, being comfortable moving in every single encounter and kind of possibility that this game can throw at you is the most important thing in the game. Like, by far, it's more important than knowing how to Azuna drop. It's more important than knowing UTs, on landing UTs is, there are things that kind of, people tend to gravitate towards wanting to know how to do, before they master movement. And mastering movement is what ultimately gives you, that freedom. It's ultimately what gives you the freedom to do everything else in the game. I hope this helps everybody, and anyone that for whatever reason hasn't discovered this game yet, hopefully this video will help you understand movement. Thanks.